In the Machinery Directive of the European Union, the EN60204 is named for the electrical equipment for machines. The basis for the European version EN60204 is the international version IEC 60204. The current version of this IEC is from October 2016. The German version DIN EN60204-1, also called VDE 0113-1, is based on this IEC version and is published in June 2019. For the use of the old version from 2007, there is a transition period up to September 21. What is the content of this EN60204-1? The standard starts with the definitions. Some words about the general requirements for electrical equipment. Also, the selection of the equipment is very important. The whole power supply of the machine is described. Physical, environmental, and operation conditions. Main connection and main disconnecting devices. The main switch is a part of this standard. Important measures against electric shock. Equipment protection as well. Equipotential bonding. All these topics are covered by this standard. An important role in this standard, they are playing control circuits and control functions. Emergency stop, emergency switching off. All these functions are described there. Operator interface and ECUs attached to the machine. Colors, symbols for these operation interfaces. Devices for the emergency stop functions or emergency switching off functions. The operator interfaces are described here in this standard. But also switchgear, the cabinet itself, arrangement, mounting and housing. The selection of conductors and cables, wiring technologies, electrical motors and related equipment related to these motors. Sockets and lighting, marking, warning signs and reference signs, and very important, of course, the technical documentation with all the important documents. And at least the test procedures to test the whole electrical equipment for a machine. The EN60204-1 has a huge amount of appendixes. Appendix A, the fault protection by automatic disconnection of the power supply. Appendix B, a questionnaire for the electrical equipment of machinery. Annex C, examples of machines covered by this standard. Annex D, current carrying capacity of overcurrent protection for conductors in the electrical equipment of machinery. Annex E, the explanation of emergency response functions. Annex F, a guidance for the application of this part of the standard. Annex G, comparison of typical conductor cross sections. Annex H, measure to reduce electromagnetic influences. Annex E, documentation information. All these appendixes should help the user of the standard to understand and to use the standard. Now we came to the changes in the IEC 60204-1 from 2016 compared to the former version from 2005. In Chapter 3, Terms and Definitions, new terms and new definitions are in. In Chapter 4, General Requirements, this chapter is completely rebuilt. Important here, switchgear assemblies, there is the link to the IEC 61439. EMC measures and the new appendix H is linked. In the environmental conditions, there is new added the altitude. The chapter vibration shock and shock resistance is newly added. In chapter 5, mains terminals and disconnecting devices. New requirements are added. A completely revision of the operator of the devices. Accepted circuits are added. Devices to interrupt the power supply to prevent unexpected startup is newly added. In chapter 6, protection against electric shock, this chapter was revised, but not many new things are in. In chapter 7, protection of equipment, there is a new link to standards about residual current devices. Also, the chapter overvoltage protection is revised. And new here in this chapter 7.10, rated short circuit current must be determined and must be labeled on a cabinet for electrical machine. Chapter 8, equipotential bonding. There is a new general picture which shows all the metallic parts of a machine which are part of this equipotential bonding system. In chapter 9, control circuits and control functions, there was a revision of the stop categories, but there are no new stop functions in. In chapter 10, operator interface and control devices attached to the machine, there was a revision of the whole chapter. New in this chapter is the actuator of the main isolator to effect emergency switching off. This was a complete rebuild chapter. And there was also a revision by the operator of the power disconnecting device to effect emergency stop. In chapter 11, switchgear, arrangement, mounting and housing, there was a revision in the chapter about the thermal effects. An overheating of the electrical equipment must be prevented. Chapter 12, conductors and cables. The general requirements are completely new written. In chapter 13, the wiring technology, there was a revision of several chapters. Chapter 14, electrical motors and related equipment. Here, the measurements of the motor housing and the criteria for the motor selection was revised. And there was also now a link to the new high efficiency motors. Chapter 15, sockets and lighting, there was a revision. Chapter 16, marking warning labels and reference marks, there was also a revision in this chapter. In chapter 17, there was a big revision of the chapter technical documentation, and also chapter 18, the tests were revised. On the annexes A to D, there was a revision, and annex F and H is completely new rebuilt. What are the most important changes in the new version of this standard? I have identified chapter 7.10, the rated short circuit current of the equipment. The rated short circuit current of the equipment must be determined and specified. No method is explicitly mentioned. Application of design rules, calculation methods, or type testings are allowed. As methods, different methods are written here, for example, methods from the IEC 61439-1, calculation methods according IEC 60909, technical rules 61912, or other methods are mentioned. Another important change here, it's the mandatory use of RCDs for socket circuits up to 20 amps. This is part of chapter 15.1. A residual current protection smaller 30 milliamps by an RCD for receptacles up to 20 amps is generally required. In chapter 10.2, actuators and markings, there was a revision of a table with new symbols for the machine operation. Now, there is a clear differentiation between switch on and switch off the power and switch on and switch off the operation of the machine. A big revision was also made in the chapter technical documentation, chapter 17. There was a reduction to the necessary documents. The documentation should include information for the identification, transportation, construction, use, maintenance, decommissioning, and disposal of the whole electrical equipment. To help to find the right documents, there is the new Annex E. In chapter 18.2, there is a new chapter testing of the power drive system. Verification of conditions for protection by automatic shutdown of the power supply under default condition must be made by testing the continuity of the protection conductor and by testing the loop impedance and the suitability of the assigned protective device. What is now the delimitation between the IEC 60204-1 and the IEC 61439-1? The IEC 60204-1 is listed in the European Machine Directive and in the European Low Voltage Directive as well. The IEC 60461-1 is only listed in the Low Voltage Directive. So, for all parts related to machinery, the IEC 60204-1 must be used. Thank you very much for your attention.